it's a perfect example. HD's doing it for 30 plus years, and is competitive. You know, I mean, they're the program to beat, and then Stu comes in here, and within years, he's competing with them. You know, I mean, that's
beating me.
Exactly. Right. I mean, yeah, and that just speaks volumes to the registry, because HD's been trial and error for some time, and now that the registry's in place, you know, he's got lineage to look back on.
Able to leapfrog over all
exactly.
that.
Exactly, and Stu comes in,
take advantage of all that.
20 years later, and within years, he's at the same level of competition.
You look at a pedigree and study it, and the cow lines and all that that you can. I mean, you look through there and you know what's working. You know what's working in his herd. You know what's working in Cody's herd. And you can study it and go. And that's what I go after.
It's pretty neat. And for the guys getting in the business, it's crucial, you know. And those guys know they can get in there and they can look up the, you know, what kind of chances they have to raise a potentially ranked calf out of these kind of females, you know. So it's, you got to do it. And it's, and it's, like I said, it's great to see those characteristics breathe through. You know, I got to watch these guys cut their teeth, you know, coming up in ABBI. So it's I can call Brandon if I have an issue, or if I don't know something about one of my cows or heifers, he'll know, you know. I could call him and say, hey, what's this cow or whatever. You know?
I think if we didn't have the registry, it'd kind of, it'd be like a doctor going into brain surgery with a blindfold on. I mean, we wouldn't know what to do with what, and just be putting bulls on sets of cows that we had no idea what they'd produce or anything like that. And now you can see the lineage of 15 plus years on every bull and every cow in there. So, I mean, and then you can click further and see what they've won, what their offspring's won. It's endless.